2-in-1 bundle, ear training course for piano intervals and ear training course for piano chords. Practice that and become great at piano playing. A music lesson you don't want to miss. By Julia Whitlock, narrated by Florian Kockott. Introduction. Hi fellow music lover, congratulations on starting your music making journey. I won't waste your time with a long introduction, but let me say a few words just to get us off on the right foot. My own musical journey taught me two things that have really stuck with me. First off, nobody can buy musical skill. You can buy equipment, lessons, and gear, but never the skill itself. If you don't have much money, you're no worse off than someone who has the best instruments and gadgets available. Music is open to anyone with the right kind of passion, joy, and dedication, including you. The other remarkable thing about your musical journey is that it's never ending. Improving your musical skills will never get boring. Every little bit you learn will give you new ideas on how to expand your skills and express yourself in new ways. Ear training is one of the most rewarding skills you can develop, and it's one that you can work on every day, which makes total sense. Music is an oral experience after all. Ear training helps you turn the music you hear into music you make on your piano. This works for your own musical ideas too. When you dream up great riff or chord progression, you naturally want to sit down and play it right away. Ear training helps you do just that. This lesson is broken into several chapters. The first part focuses on interval identification exercises, starting with grouped intervals and ending with all intervals mixed up. The second part of the book focuses on extremely valuable exercises with the help of fifths. The third part is a simple yet powerful exercise that allows you to manifest the sound of each interval even more. The fourth part focuses on chord identification exercises, starting with group chords and ending with all chords mixed up. The fifth part of the book focuses on extremely valuable exercises with the help of a drone. The last part brings you very close to a real-life situation. Short chord progressions played by either a full band or a solo piano put your ears to the final test. Best of all, this lesson doesn't limit itself to dry theory. After a brief introduction to every concept, we completely focus on listening exercises to sharpen your ear. Before we start, let me share my thoughts on how to get the most out of your practice sessions. I found it absolutely essential to come up with a routine and stick with it. For example, every day after dinner, I do 5 minutes of ear training. I set a timer, jump right into it, and when the timer goes, I'm done with ear training and off to something else. It's easy to remember, and in just 5 minutes a day, I'm able to keep my ear sharp. You might prefer ear training before breakfast or over lunch, or look for little bits of downtime. Commutes and daily walks are perfect for ear training. Whatever works for you, the important thing is that you make it part of your daily schedule. Oh, and before I forget, the most important tip of all, have fun! Ear training course for piano, intervals. Practice that and become great at piano playing. A music lesson you don't want to miss. By Julia Whitlock. Narrated by Florian Kockott. Intro intervals. As with many, if not all, things that you can practice, it's a matter of purpose. Is the vision of the future ability of your ears in terms of music clear? Mine hasn't always been clear, and still, I have periods in which I'm not sure what I want. I'm sure your goals differ from mine. To get an idea, here's a list of examples. 1. Being able to tune my instrument by ear. 2. Improve my intonation. 3. Transcribing melodies and chords from recordings. 4. Playing along with recordings. 5. Impressing other people. 6. Being able to play my musical ideas. 7. Finding matching chords to a given melody. 8. Improve my improvisations. 9. improve my playing in a band. I could go on, but I hope you get the idea. Goals are very individual and ear training is a universal skill. Talking about intervals and your goals, try to find the exercises that bring you closer to those goals. In this lesson, we focus on internalizing the sound of every interval and the feeling that you relate to it. Secondly, we bring every interval into relation to a root note rather than working on isolated intervals. I hope that will suit your purpose in the end. In the following, you are going to hear 2 to 3 intervals in a random order. Each interval is played upwards, downwards, and simultaneously, and is then followed by its solution. Try to internalize and guess each interval. If you can't hear any difference at this point, don't worry. Check the intervals you're working on your instrument first. Don't forget to sing them aloud too. Take your time while doing so and come back to the listening exercises afterwards. Forget about having a song in mind for each interval. In my experience, that doesn't work well, and in a real-life situation, it simply takes too much time. Instead, try to remember the sound of each interval and the feeling it gives you. To manifest that, remember to listen to the interval, play it on your instrument, and sing it aloud. Enough talking now. Let's start. Minor second versus major second. Minor second. Minor second. Major second. Minor second. Minor second. Major second. Major second. Minor 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 second. Major second. Major second. Minor second. Minor second. Minor second. Minor second. Major second. Minor second. Major second.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.